find anything?
Not yet, sir. No.
Someone's gotta be here. Keep looking.
Sir!
We're wasting our time. There's no one here.
I know I heard something.
Hush, Yune. Please, don't cry. If they hear you, you'll give us away.
Who's there?
Is it the Dawn Brigade?
No, it was just a bird.
Thought we didn't see you?
Look, silver hair.
If it's the fortune teller, we'll be heroes. Without her, the Dawn Brigade is nothing.
Oh, the general's going to love this.
Finally.
Sir.
Listen up, lass. If you don't want to get hurt, don't struggle.
He's not alone!
Thank you. Tellius, the year 648, early summer. The northeastern nation of Dayin lost a bloody war with neighboring Crimea 3 years ago. Crimea, however, abdicated its right to rule Dayin and passed sovereignty of its former enemy to the Dayin's future is now subject to the whims of the Empire. Benyon's occupation forces have gathered all Dayin men of fighting age and put them to work in labor camps. Their work is brutal and void of purpose, designed to break both body and spirit. The remaining population faces poverty and starvation as the fields lie fallow. A band of young heroes has escaped the Benyon army to form a group called the Dawn Brigade. Fighting for a free Dayin, they alone have stood against Benyon's forces. They alone have shouldered the hopes of their nation. Among the company is a young girl named Micaiah, who is said to possess mystical powers. The people of Dayin have come to know her as the Silver-Haired Maiden. They have come to think of her as the savior for whom they have been waiting. Benyon's forces have tried time and again to capture and silence the Dawn Brigade. However, Micaiah's ability to sense impending danger has thus far allowed the Dawn Brigade to evade the Empire's grasp.
Thank you. Thank you.